Good morning. My name is Vishwa. I'm the corporate trainer working for Voice. Voice is a global training institute for English, and we are the Pan India training partner of Cambridge Assessment English. As a trainer, I used to interact with college students, lecturers, teachers, and corporate executives. And that one common question which I usually address with my students is this: Sir, I'm fluent in English. I can communicate in English. However, the fact is this, I'm not that much good in grammar. This is one type of question which I used to address. On the other hand, the students from a rural background, they used to always come with one query: Sir, I want to speak English fluently. Which grammar question I should start practicing? They are under the impression that they have to start practicing grammar in order to learn English. Through this video, I want to address these two type of questions. Is grammar necessary to learn a language? Without grammar, will I be not able to speak English fluently? Or on the other hand, had I to learn a language, what is important? All right. Now, a baby is born, a female baby, all right, and 1 month is passed by, 2 months is passed by. As we all know, it's a common saying, it's a popular saying, it's a famous saying, the mother is the first teacher. On the other hand, the teachers are the second parents. You all know this very well. Now let's come back. After 1 month or 2 months or 3 months or 4 months, what does his mother do? As you all know, naturally, the mother used to feed the baby. And once the baby is happy, what does his mother always do? The mother used to keep the baby on her lap. And now, the class begins. The teacher-student ratio is 1:1. The teacher loves the student. And of course, I don't have to tell you the chemistry between the student as well as the teacher. The student is very comfortable with the teacher. And the student always wants to be with the teacher. And the mother keeps her baby on her lap. And the class begins now. What does the teacher always do before she starts the class? Motivation. As I geographically belong to a place where my mother tongue is Tamil, I think, let me try it in Tamil, the motivation of the teacher to the student. En kannu, en chellam, en thangam, ए राजाति यम पट्ट. द टीचर मोटिवेट्स द स्टूडेंट फर्स्ट. हाउएवर द स्टूडेंट डजंट अंडरस्टैंड एनीथिंग, बट स्टिल द स्टूडेंट इज क्वाइट हैप्पी बाय जस्ट लुकिंग एट द फेस ऑफ द टीचर. शी इज द स्टूडेंट इज वेरी कंफर्टेबल. वेदर द स्टूडेंट अंडरस्टैंड्स the language or the lesson completely, the student is comfortable by just looking at the teacher. Am I right? Now, what does happen? The teacher keeps on trying. What? It starts introducing the language for the first to its infant baby. How? Let me also try in Tamil.
ங்குங்குங்கு, இச்சிச்சிச்சு, இப்புப்புப்பு, மெய்யெழுத்துக்கள்.
The child doesn't understand what the vowel is all about, what the consonant is all about, but still it listens to the teacher. It looks at the teacher. The days goes on, a week, a month. Over a period of time, the teacher will constantly try. The teacher will never give up. Who is the teacher? The mother. She'll put her heart and soul. She'll give 100%, 200% effort in introducing the sounds to her student. So after 3 months, after 4 months, after 5 months, slowly the student, nothing but her baby, will start respond to the teacher's constant effort. It will start respond to its teacher. Ng 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 p p ch m m. The magic happens after some time. M m m m m m m. That's it. It's Diwali for the teacher. When the mother listens to the very first word of her baby, that's her student, it's like Diwali. She'll go, she'll run here and there, she'll prepare sweets, she'll distribute sweets to everyone. My daughter starts speaking, my son starts speaking. How does this magic happen? The teacher-student ratio is 1:1. And what is the mode of teaching? What is the mode of introducing a language? Sounds. Sounds. How does the student learn a language? The student will listen to the sounds. Listening. Then, parallelly, the student is also looking at the lip movement of the teacher. Lip movement, listening, constantly following the lip movement of the language teacher. The third stage is practicing, that is nothing but speaking. Listening, speaking, listening, speaking. How does the baby of 1 or 2 is able to speak a language fluently? Does the baby know grammar? Or just for a lighter sense, does the baby know what an active or passive voice is? I used to always ask this question to the teachers, faculties, and as well as with the students. So it goes on like this. Listening is the first process through which we learn a language. All obviously the mother, that's how we call our mother tongue as mother's tongue, because we learn the language through mother. But you have lot of relatives, your aunt who comes and start teaching her. Yes, in Tamil we call it as Athai, Mama. Then obviously grandfather and grandmother, they always sit around the child. Tata, tata, party. So we learn a language through listening and then speaking. So learning a grammar, of course, as on when you grow, as far as writing English is concerned, for writing, communication in writing, of course, grammar is very important. However, in order to learn a language, listening is very important. So, viewers, students, listen more. Listen more. Listen to English news. Listen to English songs. Listen to speakers. Listen to trainers' presentations. Listen a lot. Slowly, you will learn how to pronounce a word, how to articulate. Yes, so listening is very important to learn a language. Thank you.